Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Boy, a great question sent in today by Canvas with what I think is probably a fairly difficult answer for a Monday. But he says, hey, I have this workbook. It's created by someone else. It has worksheets January, February, March, for example. And I go through and I build a new summary worksheet, and that summary worksheet points to the back sheets. Good enough. He gets a new workbook from that someone else, and he wants to take this summary worksheet and move it to the new workbook. Okay, so let's go take a look at the new workbook for the new year, and let's just change some data here so that way it's real obvious. I'll make this all 999. Okay, now go back to the original workbook. He knows how to take this worksheet and copy it to the new workbook. We want to right click on the summary tab, move or copy, create a copy, move it to the new year, move it before sheet January. And you would think that instead of 369, we have a much larger number because we know that January has 999s here. But when we look at the formula bar, when we copied this worksheet, it still is pointing back to the last year worksheet. Very, very annoying. And he said, well, how can I do this? How can I create a summary worksheet that's always going to point to January, February, March of the current workbook? And it's going to drive you a little bit insane. I said, I'm not sure that this is worth all the effort, but it may be. There's a great function called INDIRECT, the INDIRECT function. And basically, INDIRECT says, hey, instead of specifying exactly what address I want to look up, I'm going to build the cell reference. I want to build the cell reference. So usually we would say January exclamation point, and then, for example, cell B7. But instead of just simply putting that in as the formula, I'm going to use the INDIRECT function. The INDIRECT function, so I use January in the exclamation point. Of course, if January had a space in it, I'd have to put apostrophes in. And then I use the cell function. The cell function says, hey, give me the address of the current cell. I happen to be in cell B7 here, so I want the cell of B7. If I needed to add in other sheets, for example, if I needed to add in February, I would use INDIRECT again. Open parentheses, Feb, exclamation point, ampersand, cell, ask for the address of cell B7, and so on. I could keep doing this all the way out for March and all the other sheets. Now, you'll see that here I have an answer of 246. When we copy this formula to the new workbook, move or copy, create a copy, go to the new year workbook, click OK, this beautiful formula actually goes through and grabs the current values from January, February, and March. Solves the problem. Now, I realize it would take a long time to go through and rewrite all of your formulas that look like this in order to look like this. But if you find that you're constantly taking this summary worksheet, maybe every day, every week, and adding it onto a workbook that someone else sends you, probably well worth the time. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.